Hey guys, my name is Ruben Phoenix and welcome to the structure of a blender. So usually when I am teaching about how Blender works, I always start out with the student in getting them up to speed with all the different tools Blender gives you to create different types of character designs or 3D models or whatever it is that you want to use Blender for. So in the first lesson, we're going to be creating a very simple design of the human figure, and I call this the human figure template concept. So there's nothing really complicated about the design structure of the human figure. So we're really not going to be creating like facial features or anything. It's really more of a very basic design as a testing idea so we can use it to our advantage to understand all the different 3D modeling tools that we can use to create a base model like this and then rig it and then get into all the other features of Blender, such as UV and wrapping, texture mapping, and normal maps, right? So I'm going to keep everything in this series as simple as possible, and at the same time, it'll give you the freedom to think for yourself as to how you can take it to the next step and create all your different kind of 3D models. So what we're going to do is go under the file. I'm just going to do new over here. I'm going to go under file and load factory settings, and this will just ensure that I'm starting out at the same point as you are. So I'm going to go over a few things here in Blender that you need to know in order to be able to create the human figure model. Okay, so first I'm going to go under File, User Preferences, and under the Input tab, I'm going to click on Emulate Numpad. This is just easy so I can reach with my fingers to change the views, and I'm also going to be using the trackball navigation style, which I'll explain in a bit. I'm also going to be using the Invert Wheel Zoom direction, and this is because I am used to working with Blender on a Mac and I like the way that works, so I want to emulate that on the PC. Under the Add-ons, I'm going to enable screencast. This is something you don't have to do. I'm just doing this so you can see the keys that I'm pressing, and I'm just going to do save as default. So every time I do new, it's always going to be ready to go with all those features that I enabled. So here in your 3D view is basically where all the features of Blender are going to be concentrated on, right? So if you take a look at this window over here, you'll see a small triangle over here, then you'll see another triangle over here. So this is like his buddy. So every time you see these two pieces, this just tells you that this is a window, right? So Blender calls these a window type. So you can see that there's another window type over here by looking at these triangles, another one over here, and then another one over here, right? So basically these are window types that are glued together. Even this top guy over here, you can see that he's a window type, although he looked like a menu bar. And I can actually move these window types around just like this, right? You can compress them or expand them. The other thing is that each window type has a header, so you can right click and flip it to the top, or you can flip it to the bottom over here. Right, so each header you're going to see has this icon, and this is how you get to the 17 different window types that Blender has. So that's quite a bit of window types, but just know that the 3D view is your main focus, and all these other window types are very easy to understand because they're really there to just help you through the animation process, the UV and wrapping, and Blender even comes with a video sequence editor so you can take all your animations and put them together. So I mean, it's giving you also the ability to do VFX type of stuff. That's if you take a movie and you can add 3D models to it. And then of course you have like the node editor over here to do much more higher different type. Well, it gives you actually control over how to process materials and textures, are really about compositing either on the model or rendering out your final output. So I'm just going to be vague on some of these things over here right now, and when we hit them, we'll look at them a little more deeper. So the other thing here is that on the header, any of these headers, if they're compressed like this, I can just scroll my mouse wheel and move them around, or I can do my middle mouse button and scroll this over here. Okay, and you can also click on these and do left, and it'll just open a duplicate copy of this and change any of these to a different window type. And if you want to get rid of it, just do this and it'll just destroy that window. Right, so you can do that anywhere over here. So the other thing here that I like to mention is that if you move your mouse over this triangle, do shift key down, and just put your left mouse button down and just move it, it'll actually create a new window off that. And this is again just a window type, and you can drag this off to another screen if you wanted to. So Blender really has no dialog boxes, like modal type of dialog boxes. Everything is always presented to you up front, and this is where you really have to educate yourself as to what is all this stuff that Blender is showing you that kind of looks overwhelming, right? So it's like you can't always use some of these features here at any time. It has to be done in more of a cognitive way. So when I went under the file user preferences, you saw that it actually brought up this window. So again, this is, if you look, it's a header over here. It's just a window type, and I can switch it back again to anything, right? So just note that that's what's going on over there. So in the idea of 3D modeling, and here, since this is going to be the main focus in the 3D view, just know that in this 3D view, Blender is going to show you a left panel over here. You can see that it says Object Tools, and then it's going to be a right panel over here, which you can click on the plus sign. So I'm going to go all the way down here. So just note that this panel over here controls how things are displayed in the 3D view. That's really its main focus. So I'm just going to click on screencast to start them and icon over here. So if I want to get rid of this, I can just click on this and go all the way to the left, right? Or I can just press the N key and bring it up and take it out. And over here is the same thing, the T key to bring it in and out. So how you select objects in Blender is basically you just right click. So this is the camera, this is the lamp, and this is the object over here. Everything, if you want to select even vertices, you're going to right click them. So since we're actually going to start modeling over here, we just scroll my mouse over here, bring this down. This is the outliner, and you can also select objects by selecting them over here. So I'm going to click on, let's say, the keep the cube selected, right? And then I'm going to go in the camera and look this eye over here. I'm just going to shut it off, meaning that I just don't want to see it. And this little camera here means that it's either you can turn it off, it's never going to render, or it's going to render over here, right? So here's the 3D cube. I'm going to do control and left mouse button over here. I'm going to type this in my figure. Okay, and that's how you can name objects. So just know that over here, if I do N, the item name is also over here, right? And you can collapse these, or any of these panels, you can click them and drag them to wherever you want them. Okay, so here I'm just going to do N. So that's the basic concept of how all these window types are pretty much just appearing what Blender feels that you might need to start out your project. You can also go under here and change the way the window types are. So here, this is like the animation. All the different window types, again, you can just create your own over here. So I'm just going to go back to the default over here. And this is my scene over here that I'm working on, right? So you can have multiple scenes in Blender. So let's get out of this. So the other feature that you want to be aware of in Blender is that you can always do the spacebar at any time and type in anything and search for commands, right? Just type in screen or whatever it is that you want to. Okay, so having said all this, we're now going to take a look at creating the human figure model. So in doing that, I'm going to now start talking about the 3D view. So if I press on my one key, right, you can do this on the numpad. So it's going to show me my front view, 3 is going to be my right view, and 7 is going to be my top view, right? So we're going to be using these keys quite a bit. So if I press down the middle mouse button, I can actually start to rotate around the object. So the way the trackball system works is when you have your mouse in the middle, you can actually rotate around the object in any way that you want to. And if you go on kind of like here on the right, you can tilt the view. That's the whole point of the trackball system. So the other thing is that if I press the 5 key, I'm going to be in ortho view. So here it's taking out the perspective. So now if I do 1, you'll see that it gives me this grid option over here, right? And this is what you want to do when you're actually starting to build models. So, and at any time I can just do middle mouse button and move around over here. So let's go to the front view and do tab over here. So now I'm in edit mode, so you'll see that I can select any of these vertices, and we'll talk about all this in a second. So just stay in your front view. So yeah, I can do that with the tab key, go into solid or edit mode. So if you take a look over here, if I do tab, it's in object mode and then edit mode. Okay, and then it has all these other features over here. So just be aware of edit and object. So I'm going to be in edit mode. So in the same way, it's going to be default in solid view where I can see the object. I can do wireframe up here. I can do that with the Z key also. So now I'm going to, and if I want to deselect everything, I can do A, and if I click on A, it's going to select everything over here. So I'm going to do W, and I'm going to click on subdivide over here. So it's just going to give me much more vertices to work with, right? So what I'm going to do is A to deselect. Now, the way you can select vertices is you can, like I said, you can just right-click on any of these vertices, okay? Like this, any of these, just right-click them. And anytime if you, let's say, right-click and move your mouse, you can move these vertices and it will be stuck to your mouse. If you right-click again, it'll just cancel it, okay? And let's say if I move this vertice like this with the mouse, like this, right? So it's going to be attached, and if I left-click, it's going to be there. If I want to undo that, I can do Control-Z to undo that, or I can do Shift-Control-Z to go forward, right? So meaning redo it. So Control-Z to undo that. So I'm going to do A to deselect. So the other way you can select vertices is you can press down the Control key and left mouse button and just select all these vertices like this. So it's going to select all the faces also. Okay, that's one way to do it, A to deselect. The other way you can do it is just press the C key. You can scroll your mouse wheel to make this guy bigger, and if I press the left mouse button, it's just going to keep adding vertices. If I do the middle mouse button, it'll just deselect everything over here. Okay, and if you right click, it'll get out of it. So in the same way, if I right click a vertice like this, if I select it, let's say this, I've selected the vertice. If I select it again, it'll just deselect it. See this over here, like deselecting meaning that right now it's selected. So if I press the shift key down and select it, I can add to it. And if I don't want it, I can click on it with the right mouse button and it'll deselect. My right mouse button acting a little weird, so that's why it's doing that. So A to deselect. The other way you can also do is just do B and select all these with box select. Okay, so we're almost ready to do the human figure. I just need to go over one more last thing, and if you do the Z key, you can also select everything. So here I'm just going to do, let's say, box select. And if I do middle mouse button, you can see that it only selected these vertices and it didn't do these. This is because over here you have to actually select this icon over here. So if you click it, it'll become white, and you can see that now I can just right click any of these vertices. So if I go back to my front view, A to deselect everything, and now let's say with the lesser select, I select all these, it's going to do the same thing. And just select all of them. So now notice that over here, this icon, if I press Z, that icon goes away because you don't need it. It's always going to select everything that way. So let's go ahead and A to deselect. So now let's go ahead and select all these and X and delete these vertices over here. So what this is going to do, just give me a half of a cube over here. So I'm going to go here in the properties window type and now go to this little spanner icon, and you'll see that Blender gives you these modifiers. So modifiers are really, think of them as these theories that you can use to create very advanced objects, right? So here you can see that I'm just going to add the mirror modifier. So this obviously means that whatever I do on the right side, it's just going to mimic on the left side. So you can also select on this, so you can even regardless. So for example, if I click on this and press the G key, it allows me to move the vertices. It'll do the same thing. If I right click, it'll just cancel this. Okay, I'm going to enable clipping on this over here. So you can take this, you can have it on or off. This just means I can select it over here on this side also. Okay. The other thing here, I'm going to add the subdivision modifier also. So the subdivision modifier is just, if I do the Z key, you'll see that it gives me much more vertices, right? So it's like this is the cage that I'm going to move around, and this, the object inside is going to deform here. So it's good. It's a really cool thing to use if you want to create organic looking objects. It's used for multiple purposes. So once I can also increase this just to show you that it'll give you much more faces. And once I'm happy with the object, I can simply apply it if I want to, right? This means that it will actually create the object with all these faces, and this thing will go away. In the same way, you can also apply the mirror modifier. Not all modifiers can be applied. For example, in the armature modifier, you cannot apply this. It basically has to be attached to the object in order for the rigging system to work. So, even in the collision and simulation, right? So it's like these objects that you want, this, basically these are theories that you want to attach to them, right? So right now the mirror is attached, and if I applied it, it would actually become part of the object. But in the armature case, if you apply it, it'll basically just disappear. It won't do anything. Okay, so anyways, I'm just going to keep this on one. So the other thing that you can do is, rather than move the cage, you can actually click on this, and now you can actually just modify the actual surface version of the modifier. Okay, so I'm just going to do A to deselect this. So now to create the human figure, now make sure that this is selected over here. I want to use the grid system over here to create that model. So here I'm just going to click on this magnet button, and this just means that every time I move, anything is just going to snap to these grid system over here. So just know that this thicker white line in Blender stands for one Blender unit when you're starting out Blender. So this is basically 1 meter in Blender. So this box is 2 meters by 2 meters. So when we create the figure, it's going to be pretty huge, and we can really scale it down to 2 meters because this is how the Rigify system is going to work. So having said all this, let's start now creating the human figure. So I'm just going to select all these. I can now right click to get out of that. I used the C key over there. So if you do G, it'll just start moving it. If you right click, it'll cancel that. Or you can just use these arrow keys and do 1, 2, 3. So this is just giving me the idea for the human head over here. I'm going to do A to deselect this. And if I do the shift key and middle mouse button, I can now move around the 3D view. So you notice that not all keys are actually shown in this little guy over here. If I do the control middle mouse button, I can actually micro zoom over here, right? Or I can just simply scroll my mouse wheel to zoom in and out. So what I want to do is now, like I said, A to D. So like I'm just going to select on these and right click. I'm going to come down one grid unit over here. I'm going to do E to extrude, and it's going to add more faces and come down one grid unit over here. Shift middle mouse to pan it, E to extrude, and come down over here again. And this is just basically going to give me the idea for the human head here and for the human neck, and A to D select. So now if I do control R, I can move my mouse like this. You'll see this little purple line here. This is really an edge loop. So if I left click, it'll attach to my mouse. If I right click, it'll just snap, stay in the middle between these two guys. So if you do middle mouse button, you can see that it actually created more vertices here, and this is what is called an edge loop. Okay. So what I want to do is, having leaving this selected, I can just do C and just select all these, right? And now you notice that I accidentally clicked it and it went away. So if you remember the last action, you can just do Control Z and it'll just select them back. So I just selected all these faces over here. I'm just going to press E and it'll attach to my mouse. I'm going to right click to cancel this. I'm going to do scale 1, 2 snaps, do scale on the X axis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So you can scale on any type of axis. So I'm going to press the 3 on my numpad to go to the right view. I'm going to scale on the Y axis, do 1, 2, 3. So now I'm going to move this over here. Like I said, you can do the G key, and you can just use these. You do 1, 2, 3. So here I'm just defining how the neck is going to be for my model. So I'm just going to do C over here, right click, and click on the blue arrow, do 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to do 1, 2. over here, right? So I'm just defining how the back of the neck is going to be over here. So what I want to do is now just click on this vertice over here. Now if I go to my front view, I can press the Z to look at this and just do 1, 2, 3, okay? And this is, you can see I'm just modifying how the object looks. And anytime you can just do Tab to see the whole model and even increase this if you just want to see what is going on here. You can even leave that on if you want to. It doesn't really matter. I just have it on pretty low over here, right? So what I want to do is, because we're really just going to be using this to create the model, the template concept, and at any time you can add a subdivision and make it much more higher quality over here. So let's just leave that on 3, right? So anyways, A to D select. So go ahead and select this and do 1, 2, 3, 4 to define the area for the jaw. Click on this one from the front and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 over here. Okay, so this is just defining some of the front area over here. So here, click on this where the neck is, do 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I can just do simply Control R and left click and right click. And this is just going to define the bottom of the jaw over here. Later we'll come here in the back of the neck. Now, here for the A to select, A to D select. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do Control R and add an edge loop over here, left click, okay, and then right click, and A to D select. I'm going to do C, select on these guys, and it's probably better to right click over here so it doesn't keep doing that. So I'm just going to do 1, 2. So anytime, let's say if you mess up, like I said, you can do Control Z over here. Right, so I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm just going to do 1 over here and A to D select. So I'm going to right click this, shift key down, and right click this one, do the front view. I'm going to do 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this is just defining how the back should be over here. So the other thing I like to do is just click on this, shift key down, click on this. Just do one time like this over here, and just do one time like this over here to bring it in, and just do the same thing over here, maybe just one time like this and one time like this over here. Okay, that's what I like to do when I'm creating my model. So I'm just going to do A to select, A to D select, just make sure I didn't have anything selected, and right click to get out of this. So I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to come down 1. Again, this is just the base model of a template concept. You can take it to the next level or even add features to it, whatever it is that you want to do. So I've got this defined over here. I'm just going to do Control R, left click and right click over here. Then I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to show you a cool feature here is that right now is everything's just going to be a little checkered over here. So you can at any time, right? So if I have this, if I hover my mouse, so you have to experiment with this, obviously. I'm going to hover my mouse here on top and do, and actually get rid of this sign and do V, right? So you'll see that it splits it. If I right click and Control Z, that it'll go away. So if I now hover my mouse over here, do V, it'll split it over here, right? Control Z that. So I'm going to Control Z that, V, okay. So now it's going to split over here. So the reason I'm showing you that is because what V does is basically rip it apart. So it depends on where your mouse is. It acts differently each time I've tried it, right? So if I do, sometimes I have to hover on my mouse to rip it. So if I do here, this is really the rip I'm looking for, right? So I'm just going to have this selected, do shift key down, select this guy, select this guy, and this guy. When you have 4 vertices selected, or 3, but you want to have 4 selected, just do F, it'll create a face over here. So now I can right click this and just start to define a little bit of the jaw over here. So I'm just going to click on this and just do the red arrow and take it in a little bit over here, and maybe bring this out a little bit more, 3 in, bring it to the back, right? And this is, as I said, you can just do Tab and you'll see that this is how you can define much more better features on the human face over here, right? So that was like one feature you should be aware of. Now, like I said, we're not really interested in advanced topology, but usually what you want to do is, like I said, over here you would think about the muscles of the neck. So you don't have to really do it in this concept here, because you can always use the sculpting tools later on and then go through the process of retopology to actually come up with the correct topology if you want to. Right now we just want a base model. right? So you can move these vertices around if you want to create whatever it is that you want to do. It doesn't really matter here. So here we've got pretty much this guy defined now. So what I want to do is A to select, A to deselect. I'm now going to start to define the rest of the human body over here. So I'm going to do C and select all these. Okay, and now I'm going to just bring it over here to where the grid is. Now notice I didn't have the magnet attached. So maybe I do Control Z and do magnet over here. So now I'm just going to bring it three times over here to where this grid was, because I originally moved it inside for the head. I'm going to do E. I'm just going to bring it to this one Blender unit over here. I'm going to do Control R, left click, and right click over here. Okay, and then now I can select any edge. So if I do Alt key and right click this, it'll just select this whole edge. So I want to get rid of this edge. I can just do X, and I have all these options to delete things. I'm just going to do get rid of the edge loop over here. So the reason I'm doing this is because, again, this is just basic topology concepts, but you want to actually create the shoulder in a very special way so it doesn't collide and it moves correctly. So I'm going to show you a simple way of doing it. You can think of all these things, these advanced topics, later on for yourself. I'm just going to do C and select this and right click. So it'll actually select all these over here, right? So what I want to do is come in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 over here. And I'm just going to do A to deselect. So there are multiple, what I want to do is actually select these. So there are multiple ways of selecting this. Right now I have vertices. Now notice that I have this. So if I click this, I can either click it, do shift, click on this one and add to it. I can just use the C key and add to it like this, right? It'll just select all the faces. Or I can just click on the faces and A to deselect. I can just right click this, shift key down, and right click this to select it, right? There are multiple ways. So just note that over here, you can even do Control Tab, and this is a short way of quickly selecting these. Regardless, what we want to do is make this is on and just switch back to the vertices mode. You got to just make sure that these two guys are selected over here. So I'm going to do E to extrude one time and come out. I'm going to do E to extrude 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I can rotate. So if I do the R, it'll actually allow me to rotate, right? Regardless of what I'm doing, I'm not going to confirm everything. Or I can just simply type in minus 45 at any angle and do Enter key. I did negative 45. So now I'm just going to click on this arrow, do 1, 2. So start to define some of the basic ideas of the shoulder over here. So I'm going to click on this, right click, and do, let's say, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do Control R, left click, right click, and do left click, right click, so I can get the arm out. So like I said, you can at any time select on this, right, and do Control Tab and faces, and maybe you just want to shift key down this way, or just basically just select these four guys over here. So here I'm just going to do E and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, I'm just going to do. Now I'm going to actually, rather than rotate this, I'm going to do scale on the x-axis. I'm going to type in 0 on the keyboard. So what this will do is, regardless, if you look at, if you want a bunch of vertices to be, let's say, vertical or horizontal, you have to look at the, let's say, if I want them on to be straight on the z-axis, I'm just going to look at the x-axis. So that's why I did scale x and I did 0 and everything lines up straight over here. So then I'm just going to click on this blue arrow, do 1, 2 over here to bring it up a little bit, okay? So here I'm just going to click this back over here, A to D select. So now, I mean, you can just click on this a little bit over here, maybe do 1, 2, and bring it down one time over here to start defining this. And usually I just click on this, right? Again, this is freedom to think here. You can do whatever it is that you want to do. So I'm just going to click on these two. And let's say bring this up over here to just define, begin to define some of the basic concepts of the shoulder. Again, this is not a super realistic human figure, it's just a base model. I'm going to select on these guys, these three over here. I'm going to do the front view, do 1, 2, 3. Now I'm going to rotate this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? And this is just how the muscles will go over the base model concept in A to D select. Now notice everything is basically checkered here, and we'll actually make this a little better and think about some of the curves of topology. Again, you probably will want to go through the process of topology concepts if you're trying to get it to, let's say, in a video game. But you can It'll still work out fine when you're animating it. I'm just telling you that you can do that if you're not happy with the way, if you don't like checker patterns. But we'll move them around to actually fix that. So now let's actually create the arm. So here I'm just going to show you how to create the arm. So it'll just magically appear, right? And here I'm just going to click off the magnet, and I'm going to bring this over here and click the magnet back. So what you want to do is actually click on this vertex first and do the right view, do G12, click on this one, G12, and click on this one, G12, and click on this one, G12, and left. Okay, so this is really the back of your arm over here. I'm going to do Control R over here and add an edge loop over here. Left click, right click, click on this vertex, do 3G and bring it out. And this will just help me understand where the tricep is going to be. So to create the arm, I'm just going to use a very simple method over here. Again, it's all about just understanding how 3D modeling works, right? This is just the basic concept. Typically, you want to create the base model and sculpt it using the tools, really sculpt all the high quality details and use normal maps and stuff like that, right? So what I want to do is just do E and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm just going to bring it out 7 over here. I'm going to scale this one time over here. Then from the top view, I'm going to do G and bring it to the front over here. Then I'm just going to do E12 over here, scale on the Z123. And from the top view, I'm going to scale this on the Y one time. One or two times, up to you. I'll just do one time over here. So this gives me the, it opens up this area over here. So I can just right click these guys over here, top view, do G and bring it out. And this is really just the basic idea of the bicep over here. Okay. For the chest, I'll show you how to fix that real quick. So A to select, A to D select over here. So I'm just going to do select all these now. And now what I want to do is do E and extrude this to the next grid. Do S scale on Z123. Then from the top view, I'm just going to do G and move it to the back. Do Control R, left click, right click. Oh, Control Z that. Okay. And then do, I'm going to do scale and one time over here for the four arms. Okay. Then I'm going to do C and just select this again. Next, I'm just going to wrap this up, do E, and just come to the grid space over here, scale Z, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then from the top view, I'm going to do scale Y, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm just going to move it one time over here. So this is now just your forearm over here. So if you do Tab, you'll see that I've got the triceps, the four back of the forearm, the area of the elbow, the biceps over here, and this is your shoulder, which we'll look at a little bit later over here. So just do Tab over here. So now what we want to do is I want to actually twist it because I want the hand to be in a flattened area. So I'm going to do on my right view, I'm going to rotate minus 90. Okay. Then I'm going to move this, do Alt and click on this edge loop, go 3 to rotate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Usually I do it. Do Alt and click on this next guy, do 3, do rotate 1, 2, 3. Right, so I just twisted this whole area over here. And this is how the Rigify system is expecting the arm to be anyways. So let's go ahead and talk about how can we do the hand. So just go ahead and click on this. Usually I just do E to extrude and one time, scale Z one, maybe two times, then do E to extrude and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. Then scale Z 1, 2, come in a bit, do extrude one time over here, like this, and do scale Z maybe 1, 2 times, and then do E 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? So this is just the basic idea of how the arm is going to, hand is going to be. So I'm going to click on this to get rid of this, go back into my face mode, and A to D select. I'm going to now start to define basically how the arm should be. So if I select extra, I can just middle mouse button right click to get out of it. So I just selected these, do the top view, do E to extrude and come out one time, A to D select, do the same thing over here, just select it with the C, right click, and just make sure you didn't select anything over here. And 7, and then do E and come out. So one thing to note here is that, for example, if I just want to rotate around this hand over here, you'll notice that it seems to be focused over here, right? So if I want to do that from the top view, I'm just going to do shift and make it over here. From the three view, I'm just going to make sure that this is in the middle. And this is how you now rotate at any point in 3D space in the track view system like this. So anyways, top view over here. So I'm going to do control R, you left click 1, 2, 3. Okay, maybe did 4. Just to, don't worry about that. So here I'm just going to click on this. Now I'm going to bring out the thumb. And here you just want to think about, look at your hand and look at how the thumb is going to be. It's pretty straightforward. So I'm going to do E, 1, 2, then do G to here, rotate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, over here, then scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, over here. Then now from the right view, you'll see that what I want to do is actually from the front view, do G, 1, 2, right, and then from my right view, you'll see that it's kind of not right over here, so I'm just going to use rotate this. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, I don't really have to count this stuff, I'm just making it easy so you can follow along, but you will let go of some of that stuff, counting stuff in a bit. I'm going to do E and do 1, 2, then do E again, 1, 2. Okay, so this is just going to define how the thumb is going to be over here. So it's kind of a little flat, that's fine. Again, this is just a base model. I'm just going to do Control R and left click and right click. So it'll just add an edge loop. Now you can also do Alt S and just scale on the normals. In order to do that, you have to take off this guy over here. Alt S, and you can see I can make it a little more fatter over here, just like this. Okay. So the other thing is that we obviously know that the thumb is not going to be like this. If you look at your hand, really this is the top area, but it needs to be twisted. So I can actually select these by doing Alt and it selects the whole edge loop. You can do Shift Alt and select this like this, right? So be careful where you click this. If you do this, it'll select this, right? Or you can do A to D select. Or just simply just come in here and just select these guys, right click, and select this guy over here, right click. This is where you now you can look at the thumb over here. Just look at it directly like this and now rotate this, right? Just like this, and then start moving things around a bit as to how do you want the thumb to be over here, right? So I'm going to bring it down, right? And now you'll start to see that it's going to do some things over here, and that's fine. Again, this is just a template concept, right? You'll see that when we use the Rigify, it's going to work out very nicely. So I'm just going to actually bring some of these down over here. And again, this is, we're getting a little off track here, but you know, this is how you modify stuff. So here, like I said, you can click on, you can do Control Tab and just go to the face mode, do Alt and make sure that this selects over here. And I can do Alt S and actually bring this down a little bit over here if I want to. I can even add more edge loops, it doesn't really matter. Right, we just want to get it. So if you do Tab, you'll see that it's just a very simple design of the hand over here. So next we need to create the fingers over here, and the way we're going to do this is we're actually going to turn this off, and you're going to get the actual cage that I was talking to you about. I'm going to stay in vertice mode and top view, A to select, A to deselect, and now I'm going to actually decrease this, and for now actually just leave it like this. Oh well, right, you want to actually have this off. So what I want to do is I'm just going to keep this on 1. I'm just going to do C and select all these guys over here. Okay, so now notice that when I selected this, it only selected the top. And the reason for this is I had this off, right? So I have to have it on. So I'm just going to do C and select all these guys again, right? Just to make sure you got everybody. So now I can press Y. And what this does, if I do the red arrow, it'll actually separate this as an object. So one thing to note is that, let's say if you're in face select mode, whenever you have, it's still part of the same idea of the object, it's just completely separated, it's not connected. So if you just hover your mouse in face select mode and do L, it'll actually select all those vertices that are connected to that one specific object. So just remember that as a tip. So anyways, I'm going to go back into the vertex mode over here. So I'm going to now do Alt and just click on this to get this edge loop, to X and delete the edge loop over here. And I'm going to actually put that much later back. So what I want to do is, now you'll see that, again, it just selects this. So like I said, you can actually, even in vertex mode. If you do L, it's not going to select anything, but if you like move your mouse near your edge over here, it'll select everything. So just scale this on the y-axis and just bring it up a little bit over here. So it's just going to start to give you the finger. So from the right view, what I'm going to do is fix all this stuff. So here I'm just going to select all these, right? So it's kind of messed up here. Let's align it better. So like I said, I want them to be straight on the horizontal axis. I just have to look at the vertical one. So if I do scale Z 0, it'll just straighten them out. So I can now actually rotate this over here and just think about just a little bit of the angle over here. So next I'm going to do the same thing, select all these and do scale Z 0. And over here, I'm just going to rotate this like this a little bit, maybe bring it up over here, A to D select, right? So again, you can do this all day. You can just click on this. Now, here I'm going to scale on the X, scale X 0 to straighten that up, A to D select, select on this, scale X 0, right? Again, the point here is not why am I doing it, I'm just showing you how some things work in Blender. So what we want to do is now start to define the finger. So I'm going to do Alt and click on this. It's just going to select the whole edge over here, 7. I'm just going to use these arrows so just to position these, and Alt and click on that edge to how should the four fingers should be over here. Going to do Control R, go to Edge and Edge Loop over here, and let's say over here, Control R. I want to separate these fingers, Control R, edge loop over here. And I'm going to do Control R, select on this and do it this way over here. And A to D select. So notice I have this selected. Next, what I'm going to do is now I can scroll this with the C and just select on these and right click. Now I can do X and delete these faces now to create a cut over here. Do C and do the same thing with all of these. Okay, so now what we're going to do is put everything back together, right? So I'm going to zoom in a little bit. So I'm just going to do C. Like I showed you on the jaw, if you have four vertices selected, you can make a face. So it's going to select this vertice in the bottom and this one. Stay in your top view. Just press an F and it will connect it. Now the finger's coming back together. So do the same thing for everything over here and even for here, right? So if I select this, right click to F, because these are four, it'll select it. Over here, here, right click F. So I'm going to do this for all of them. Okay, so I've got all the fingers done over here. So we don't really want to get into creating realistic fingers here, but I'll show you enough information that you can think about it. Again, you can always go to the retopology process and do that for yourself. So what I want to do is right now, what I want to do is actually move these fingers a little bit. So just look at your hand, how this is done. So just look at your nail size. This is going to be over here. Right, this is going to be positioned a little bit over here, let's say, and I'm just going to position this over here down here. Okay, so next what I'm going to do, make sure everything's here, do put that edge loop back, Control R, and put them back, left click, right click. Okay, so now what I like to do is just go into the top view and select on this guy, and then shift key down and select on this guy with the right mouse button and go to the top view. Scale on the Y, oops, hang on a second. I clicked on the wrong key over there. I'm going to select on, actually take this off over here, make it easy, and just select on this, okay, and top view. So I'm going to scale on the Y, and I'm just going to come in a bit over here, right? And I'm going to just do it on both of them like this, on the top view. Scale on the Y and come in a bit, A to D select. Select on this, and here scale on the Y and come in, select on this, scale on the Y, come in like this over here. Okay, and this will just round up the fingers a bit over here. So what you might want to do is also at this point, I don't have to worry about that right now. Well, maybe we will. worry about that now. So just go ahead and select on these guys and these guys over here, right? And then maybe you want to scale this on the Z and just bring it down a bit over here, right? Because this part is going to be a little shorter over here anyways, right? I just like to take care of that right now. There are multiple ways of doing the hand. Anyway, so what we want to do is now do Control R and put in 5 loops. So if I scroll my mouse, I'm going to get like 3, 4, and then 5. Left click, Control R over here, 5, and then Control R. And just make sure I have 5 of these. Control R, 5 of these. Next, I'm just going to click on the faces. So if you think about this, what I want to do is over here, I'm just going to do E to extrude and scale this in. Okay, E to extrude and scale this in. E to extrude. I'm going to do this on purpose here because what I want to show you is that this is just the basic concepts of topology where you have to think about, right, it's really over here. If you look at this, this is what's going on. So let's actually keep this back on now. We actually don't need that. So when the fingers bend, you want to be able to have this idea of topology, so when it bends, it doesn't actually have to bend on these, right? So it's going to have enough vertices to bend over here. So I can just do Control R and put left and right click, left and right click, left and right click, left and right click. So now when it bends, it actually bends over here, and that's how you make joints bend. Okay, so we're going to do the same thing over here in the face mode. Do E, and you can scale it in if you want to. Doesn't really matter, really. E to extrude, E to extrude, and E to extrude. Okay, and I'm just going to do Control R. Oops, Control R. Left click, right click, left click, right click. Oops, Control Z, Control R. Left click, right click, and left click, right click. So now let's say you want to say that, okay, well, I should have really, maybe I should have scaled them in, right? So yeah, just go into the Z, press this, and scale it in a bit, right? No big deal. So I'm just showing you all the different things here. So what I want to do is now scale this in, scale this in, and select and scale this in. Okay, so I've got this defined. So how can we make it now? We can actually now click on these edges. So where this is in the middle, I'm just going to select on this one, shift key down. Actually, it's this one, not this one. And this one, come on, this one, and this one, okay? If you look at your fingers, how they're being positioned. So from my front view, so I'm just going to do this, and it's going to just bring it up a little bit over here, right? So it'll start to create the finger, so I can do the same thing over here, right? Click on these guys from the front view, do G, and bring it in a little bit. So obviously, it shouldn't be like this, so now I can just select on these, shift key down, and just select these, this one over here too, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, come on, this one, this one, this one, this one. And then from the front view now just bring them in, right? So this will start to give you your fingers, A to D select. So the other thing that you can do now is actually go into the edge loop over here and just click on edge, okay, click on this, shift key down, click on this. This one, come on, this one. And from the front view, now I can just do G and start to just think about a little about the finger. So, right, so you might have to come in here and individually actually just click this one. Now, if I'm in the front view, I can do Control 1 and go to the opposite view and do G. So, I'm just going to click on these now, shift key down, this one, and this one. And do my front view, do G and just bring them out, right? So here we've got very nice fingers already done. So let's go ahead and connect this back. So the way we're going to connect this back is just make sure that this is off over here, A to D select. The multiple ways of connecting vertices, first what we have to do is select all these. Okay, actually, let's just do it with the mouse. So just select these guys over here. Okay, and now you can go, well, before I do that, I'm going to do Alt-M, and it'll allow me to merge at center. The other way is that right over here, it also has its function over here. So here you'll see that it's much more easy to do it this way, right? So here I can just do C, come over here, do click on, like, so it won't let me click, I have to actually right click and do merge, and I can just do it center, right? A to D select. So if you don't want to, because it's kind of awkward to do the Alt M, I'm just showing you that you can just do it from here, merge at center. So we have to do this also over here. Okay, A to D select. Make sure you A to D select and do merge at center. A to D select over here. Make sure you're only selecting these guys over here. And merge at center. A to D select. Select this. Right click and merge at center over here. Okay. So now let's talk about how do we put this stuff back. Well, it's pretty easy. We can get rid of this guy. We don't need him anymore. Okay. So I'm going to go under mesh and I can do auto merging. Now what I can do is actually click on this vertice and drag it to the other vertice, but it's not going to do anything right now. You have to have snapping on and you have to click on vertex mode. This, by the way, you would do face if you are creating a new object and you want to do retopology. You would do it this way. You would click on the magnet and click on faces. So anytime you move a vertice, it'll snap to the actual object that you might have sculpted. Anyways, I'm going to do vertex. If I do G, you'll see that I get a circle over here. As soon as I move my cursor, left click, it'll merge this. Do G and merge it. Click on this, do G and merge it. And not that one, right? So you gotta be careful with this one. Do this one, and this one, this one, right here. And finally, this one over here. So just do the top view, and now you can get rid of this. So here, just do back. So you might want to move some of these things over here, right? Which we'll probably do in a second. Okay, so I've got the back down over here. One thing that I want to do is, well, we have to do just a few more things here. So I'm just going to select all these and just move them all back over here, right? So you can think about the knuckles over here. Like I said, it's up to you. What do you want to do? They're already faces in there, so you can right click and maybe extrude this, right? And maybe bring them up. It's up to you. I'm not going to put that in there, right? You have to think about that. So what we want to do is let's actually click on these edges over here and make sure we're in the top view. Maybe move them back a bit over here, okay? Just a bit. And you're going to get the web over here, so you want to select on this, and select on this one, and select on this one over here. Usually, I'm just going to move it with the blue arrow, and then from the top view, I'm going to bring this up. Like, look at that web in between your fingers, how it is, right? Pretty simple concept. So the other thing that you do want to do is you're going to look at the fingers and look at the thumb from far away and see. Like I said, you can do Alt-S to scale this whole thumb down a bit if you feel that it's kind of too big or something, whatever. Okay, so 7, A to D select. Okay, so what I want to do is now actually rotate these because you know that the palm is actually a little bit over here. So I'm going to click on this one. I'm going to just select all the important vertices that I feel are going to be what I need to rotate this small finger over here. And also select this, right? Right click. I'm going to now rotate this and bring it in a bit over here. Rotate this a bit more. And you want to do this if you want to rig something. You want to have them apart because the way the armature system is going to work, if you have something too close, it'll probably apply the weights on it. With the weight painting concept, it's just better to just do it this way. So I'm just going to rotate this over here and rotate this out. The only thing I need to now do is rotate this, and we'll be done with this hand over here. See, and I'm going to just rotate this over here, okay? And now you can go in here and just move this in a bit. And I'm also just going to swap this and just move it out. Just a bit. Just give it like a basic idea of the hand, okay? So as I said, you can always add in more edge loops over here, right? So Here you can now think about, okay, well, I probably do need to add an edge loop over here. Do Alt S and bring it in a bit for the thumb. Right, just think about the joint area. Where exactly is this thumb gonna bend over here? Right, so I'm just gonna take this off. So I know that, okay, well, this area here, right, so I probably need one right over here. Bring it in close over here. And I just need to actually click on these guys over here and do E to extrude and just leave it, right? And this will just help in bending this area of the thumb. So I probably want to do the same thing in this area over here. And one other thing you can do is just click on this and do Control E. Like, so I did Alt, click this, Control E, and you can do Edge Slide and move them a little back over here, right? So just think about, okay, well, it's going to bend over here. Control E and slide over here. I probably want to do the same thing. Maybe put it over here. I don't know, move it, whatever you want to do. And do E to extrude and maybe scale that down a bit. Well, not, I don't really like to scale it too much. Right, just bring it in. This is just the mechanics of topology that I'm just showing you. Again, this model is here to just help us understand that. So you can see that it's kind of going inside, so I can do Alt and click on these, right? You'll see that it selects too many, so A to D select. So I can just select these guys over here, right? Alt C, and do C and just select these guys over here and right click over here. Now, oh, I can middle mouse button. I can do Alt S and just bring it out a little bit over here. So it's not like that. A to D select. So we've got the hand defined over here. Okay, so now A to select, A to D select. What I want to do is define, I'm going to make sure that this is on, the rest of the body. And pretty much everything is pretty simple from here. Right, so make sure that all of these are selected over here. So I'm going to do scale X. Cancel that. I'm going to actually enable this first. Scale X 1, 2, 3, 4. Then do E to extrude 1 down. Scale X 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? E to extrude. Don't do anything here. E to extrude. Then scale X 1, 2. And then E to extrude. Scale X 1, 2. Cancel that. Scale X 1, 2, 3. Okay, and A to D select. Go ahead and select on these and just do the red arrow until they join like this and then do 1, 2. Okay, A to D select. So go ahead and select all these now. Do E to extrude in one grid unit. Scale X one time. So what I'm doing here is just defining automatically how the figure should look. This template concept. Do Control R, left click, right click over here. Do C, select these, and do scale Y one. Over here, do G, 1, 2, okay? So now do A, and now let's define the rest of the legs. Do E, come down, scale one time, G, do the back, and E, scale down, scale 1, 2. Don't do anything here, E, scale down, then do scale 1, 2, 3. Then do G, 1, 2, oops, do G, 1, 2, 3. So it can start to go in the back. I'm going to do actually, I'll just leave it at 3. Then over here, I'm going to do G one time. This is your knee area over here. This is where the muscle's coming. So we're almost done with this. E to extrude, then scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then do G to the left, E to extrude, scale 1, 2, 3, do G to the left, do E to extrude, scale 1, 2, and G to the left, E to extrude, and this just defines the how the legs should be. So here I'm going to do Control R. Left click, right click over here, one to three, and do G, and just bring it out one time for the knee. And here again, we're going to actually set that up in a second over here. So since we're here already, just do, well, actually we can't do that. Let's go ahead and define the foot real quick over here. Do C, make sure that this is over here. Do from, just going to come over here, E to extrude, and then do 1, 2, 3 over here. I'm going to do scale Z, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do G and just come down over here. I'm gonna go into my top view over here. I'm gonna do E to extrude, 1, 2. I'm gonna rotate one time. Gonna do E, 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5. Okay, and this is just defining how the shoe is gonna be, or the foot. Just do Control R one time, then do Control R left and right click, and do Control R over here, left click and right click, A to deselect. So go ahead and just turn this off. So what you wanna do, make sure A to select, A to deselect, and select all these guys over here, right? The, we only have deselected, do 7, top view, and do one time like this. So on this end, I'm going to do C and just select all these guys over here. Do C. Just only select these. Don't select that guy. Right? And then from the top view, I'm going to do G and one time like this. So now I'm just going to right click this, shift key down, this one, and this one. So basically select 4 of these, do the front view, do G, 1, 2, 3. So define the foot, click on this guy, do G one time over here. Next, go ahead and click on this one, shift key down now, select these. And one is the front view, control one is the back view. Scale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right, you can just do 5 over here. So here I'm just now gonna go to the bottom over here of the foot, and select on these guys over here. So 7 is the top view, control 7 is the bottom view. I'm just going to do scale 1, 2, 3, 4, and do G to the left, to the right, right? So it just defines the basic idea of the foot over here. So in the Rigify system, it really doesn't give you the ability, although you can add it later, doesn't give you the ability to do the toes or anything. So you can now just decide, well, you know, it's up to you. For this character, I think we'll actually just leave it like this over here. Now, if you want to define the toes, we can actually do that with the same concept over here, right? I can take that off over here in the modifier, and I'll start to define, well, how should the toes be defined over here, right? So in the same way, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to be quick about this because, like I said, you can't really control how the toes are going to be. So I'm going to do the Y over here. Okay, so it's going to just separate the fingers. So I can just do G, oops, sorry, A to D select. Undo that. You got to have to select it. Select on these. Okay, so the whole thing is selected. From the top view, do Y to separate it, and just get rid of this guy here, and do G to just separate it a little bit. So now just think about the toe over here, get rid of this over here, right? So I want to actually scale these down a bit, so I'm going to actually select this also on the other side of the foot. No, I'm not going to do that. I am only going to select these. So from the right view, I'm just going to bring this down because this is how the toe is supposed to be anyways. I'm just going to select on these guys and bring it down also like this, right? So this is like giving you a better curve over here. So if you want to do the toes, it's going to be pretty simple. Just like I said, it's the same thing. Do Alt and get rid of this first. Delete the edge loop. Then from the top view, do Control R and think about the toe over here. Control R. I'm going to separate it over here. So first finger over here. Control R. And then Control R. So you'll get like four of these over here, right? Control R and put that edge loop over here, right? And the other thing you might want to do is also click on this and just make this, oops, gotta have this on, and make the tool a little more bigger over here on this end, okay? So it's the same thing, just select these guys, make sure that this is on over here to do this, X and delete the faces. So you're gonna do the, it's the same thing that we just did up above for the hand, X and delete the faces, C over here, X and delete the faces, C over here, X and delete the faces. Click on this, do F, A to deselect. So I'm doing the same thing, just selecting these guys over here. F, A to deselect. So you get all of these first. Okay, whew. Okay, so here we've gotten the toes. So like I said, you can think about what you want to do with this stuff. So usually I just come in here and select this, and I'm just going to bring them down a bit over here, okay? And you can also just put edge loops here. Now, like I said, the Rigify system is not going to give you the ability to control R and do left click and right click, put that edge loop over here. So it's the same concept. I mean, like it's not going to give you the ability to bend these, but you know, it's up to you what you want to do. So I'm just going to get rid of this. Press C and do the same thing just like I did above. Right. So I'm going to scale this. What I want to do is switch to normals because it's kind of on the angle. No, I don't want that. I'm going to do this a different way because it's kind of on the angle. I'm going to have to do it like this, okay? I'm going to scale this in like this. Okay, and over here, I guess I'll do the same thing. Scale it in just a little bit, the whole thing here. And you want to do it over here. And just scale it in. So now, what I want to do is, you want to think, okay, well, the big toe is really just going to have, come on, Control R, it's going to have one edge loop over here now, and I guess I'm going to do two over here, right? Again, this is not bending really, so I'm just going to do, well, actually, let me Control Z this. Because what I want to do is actually first rotate these, rotate them so they look a little better over here. Okay, so now I can go to 7 and actually just think about. Okay, so now I'm going to do Control R and just move it over here. Just do two of these over here. Right, you can do 3, 2, doesn't matter. Like I said, think about the design of this. Like I said, it's not really going to bend that much anyways. So what I want to do is actually A to D select. And click on this, C, and just select all these guys over here. Right? And I'm going to, from the right view, I'm just going to bring them up a bit. looks a little better over here. And maybe scale this in and push this notch up, right? For some reason I selected it. So now this guy, just gonna bring him up over here. Okay, so again, now you can just put this back over here and start to define the foot. So now the thing about this is that we're really using the subdivision modifier to do the work for us, so we don't have to worry about triangles. So here I'm just going to do again the same thing. I'm going to do merge at center. Okay. So even if you make a triangle, the subdivision modifier inside is not going to do that. Okay, so that's actually an issue. You don't really want to have triangles in your models, but you can. But in video games, it doesn't really even matter. But everything is a triangle. Even if it has four of these selected, there's really a line going through to create these triangles over here, right? The subdivision modifier is going to do that anyways. On these, okay, so now we've gotten all this done. So what I want to do is select on this, control E and slide, and kind of like bring it a little more over here. Well, maybe actually I'll leave that be over here. Right, so the question is, how do you attach this? Okay, so we actually need one more over here anyways, control 1 R. We're gonna have like two of these guys over here now. Okay, so what we can do is, again, mesh auto merging. Make sure you take this off after you're done with this. So I'm gonna do this one, vertex. I'm gonna do G and now first connect it. Vertex mode snapping on G and oops, come on. Well, I'm not sure why it's clicking this, but the yellow thing is off. I'm gonna do this one over here. Don't do any of these yet. Because we're gonna talk about this area a little bit. Okay, so now the question is, how do you connect these guys here? So for now, I mean, take this off, get rid of this guy. So what you can do is actually for now just move this a bit over here and now actually connect them by using the C key over here, right click, and I can do F. Regardless if it's a triangle, it's going to give you all the quads that you need in order for the Rigify to bend these guys anyways, right? Don't worry about this as a triangle because it's not giving you triangles. So I'm just going to connect it this way over here real quick. F. And this one. Actually, yeah, F. And maybe select this. F. Okay, so if you look, there, right, if I do tab, you'll see there are no triangles. It's all quads in there. Okay? So that's how I usually just connect it real quick over here. So it's the same thing over here. I'm just going to move it back a little bit. And let me do this. So make sure auto merging is off now. We don't need it. Okay, so we've got the foot in there. Okay, so we've got all the toes defined. Again, the Rigify is only going to move this whole thing as a basic idea. So I'm just going to leave that be now. Okay, so over here, number one, just going to, well, you can actually add, I believe. We can add one more here if you want, if you really care about this over here. Right, so I'm just going to, like, do this now here. when I select this, I'm just going to do a little bit of that bone. It has to be on an angle, right? So probably not going to get the ability to do that over here, but that's fine. Talking about the ankles, right? Just it's up to you. You don't have to go crazy on this. That's not the point of this. Anyway, so now we're almost there, almost there. Now we're going to go through the process of fixing quite a bit of stuff here and wrapping it up. So what I want to do is actually select here, this one on the buttocks, do three. Make sure my snapping is on. I'm just going to do 1, 2 over here. Okay. And next one, three, I'm going to make sure that this is on. And just go into vertex mode now to do C. A to select, A to D select. Okay. Select on these. And usually I do 1, 2, 3. Okay. A. And then I just select this. And I do rotate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is just defining how the back is going to be over here for my model. A to D select. Next, I'm just going to get rid of this and start selecting these guys. Do three and do 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we'll start bringing stuff up. And we obviously have to fix quite a bit of stuff, so don't worry about this. And it's really not that much to correct. I brought the neck area out 2 times, right? Okay, so anyways, so now I'm gonna click on this. We're A to select, A to D select. What we wanna do is fix up the chest. So I'm just gonna do the C, I'm gonna select these two. All these guys over here, except this one over here. Now I'm going to do W, I'm going to do smooth, and here you'll see that I can just increase. You can either do smooth multiple times, or you can just do this 8 times. A to D select. Select on these guys. Smooth, it'll all be 8. So it's technically supposed to be on 1, so I'm just going to do 3. It just, for some reason, remembers what we did last time. And just click on these now. On these, do W, smooth. And I'm going to take it to 12. A to D select. And then, usually, I just click this. And do G one time and inside to open up this area over here. Like I said, everything's kind of checkered here. We'll fix that in a bit. Almost done, almost done. I'm going to select on this over here. I'm going to do W, smooth. It's going to be on 12, so just do 8 and A to D select. One thing that I like to do is I just like to select. This is where you can now start to take this off. A to D select. Select on these and be careful how you do this now. Just do it very slightly in over here. Right, and I'm just going to move this in pretty, not too much because it'll look like a female then. Right, this is a male over here. And then we'll actually fix all this blocky stuff in a second. So I believe we're now officially done with the template concept. All we have to do is now fix the topology. This is where you can now start to think about, okay, what are the topology issues? Again, this is just basic stuff here. Showing you how this works. Well, usually what I do is to click on this, do V, and it just adds a face over here. Come on. Jesus. And do F, A to D select. So it just, here I'll show you why I did that. So if I now select on this, bring it down, I'm just defining the basic idea of the chest. Okay, so you'll see that it gives me the ability to just connect this over here, right? Just a line over here. The multiple ways of doing this over here. So I'm just going to do A to D select, select all these, then from my right view to G and just bring it out a bit over here, right? And then you can just move these over here. Again, when you start moving this stuff, it's going to kind of like punch it in, so you have to be aware of this. Three, just bring it out a little bit more over here, right? We're trying to get away from the checkered concept. So over here, I'm just going to actually select this one. Actually, select, don't select this, select this. Okay, and then from the top view, do, and just bring it out a bit, not too much, right? And now start manipulating some of these vertices over here. Right, and then over here, I'm gonna actually push this in a bit more. Oh, I don't have to worry about that because we're gonna actually do that much more rapidly. So the next thing we do is we wanna actually, oh, you know what, over here, we now want to bring out some of this stuff here, so it's not kind of like flat like this. Right, so if you do tab, you can see, and if you increase this, right, I'm getting the basic idea for the model over here that I need. What I want to do is Alt click this, Control E, Edge Light. I'm going to bring it down a bit, right, so it's not blocky like this. And once I do that, I can do C and just deselect all these until here. Now if I do Control E, Edge Light, it'll actually go back this way. We want to balance it out, basically. Get rid of the blocky stuff and do Alt, select this, and this is the same thing, Control E, Edge Light. You want to come in a bit, and if you do Control E, Edge Light, it'll actually do in, and then you can do G and bring it out a bit more if you don't like the way that Edge Light sometimes works, okay? That's that. Over here, it's the same thing. Select this, Control E, Edge Light. I'm going to bring it in because technically that's how this is supposed to be, but you'll see that it's moving the back, and I don't like that. So I'm going to do C, get rid of this until there. Control Z that, and Control E, Edge Light, and bring it in a bit over here, right? And same thing over here, Control E, Edge Light, it's going to go in, right? It's going to go out a bit over here, A to D select. So what you want to do is just balance out the vertices so they're put together pretty nicely. So one, right view, I'm going to now select on these. Bring this down a bit, bring this down a bit. So I'm just defining how the buttocks should be over here. Okay, it's Control 1, and I'll just start to manipulate some of these vertices over here and bring this over here. Next, I'm gonna just bring this in a little bit over here and now start defining the arcs for these muscles, right? So on the three, you want to just define like an arch over here. So this one needs to come in obviously a bit more over here. Okay. And when you have the topology and a curve, it's going to actually work out pretty nicely over here. So one thing that I like to do, like I said, now I'm going to test this out quickly. If I do V, it'll actually split this. Right. So notice how I did that. Let me Control Z that. I select this as vertices, hover my mouse here, do V. It separated this. This is because when the leg bends, I want to actually have this case of this topology here, so when it moves, it doesn't really mess around with this area over here, right? So a the ideas of topology can become, it's a fascinating subject. It has to do with how your character moves, how the skin moves on the character. You really don't want to have checkered patterns, obviously, so I'm just gonna, in this case, we don't really have to worry about too much over here. So I'm just gonna, I guess, move this down, maybe, right? Or you can move it up. I'm just gonna do it down, right? A lot of artists actually, that's why when you go to retopology, you actually think about all those things. So the other thing here is that I'm just gonna select on this. Like I said, I need to create this important concept here for the knee. I'm going to do E to extrude and just scale it down a bit, and from here I'm just going to bring it out. This is to make sure, as you'll see, that when we move the leg, it'll actually move very nicely over here, right? So this is one case of a topology issue over here. Now if you want to come in here, Control 1, right, you can even start pushing this stuff up over here just to give it a nice arch over here. If you want to pump up the muscle, that the whole point of this guy over here is to just help with understanding the things you can do in Blender. That's the whole purpose. Okay, so one of the thing is I'm just going to actually click this and bring it in a little bit more. This is the shin area over here. Okay, so this is fine. Looks pretty good over here. So we don't have to worry about this area because it'll actually bend over here pretty nicely anyways. Okay, this area here, control one. We don't have to worry about this area. So maybe I'll just do, I mean, if it's bugging you that it's checkered, you can get rid of that. It doesn't matter if it goes up, down, up. Right? You can't really do much with the base concept here, but you can just get the basic understandings of simple concepts of topology. You definitely have to do retopologize your stuff here. So, and you can balance out any of these areas. I'm just checking really quick. So the other thing I like to do is actually bring this up that much. Maybe bring this down, right? And really just define a little bit of the rib cage over here. Three. How the rib cage should be. Control one, and now start to define the back a bit. And if you've been through the structure of main course, you'll know as to why this area actually is this way in a lot of people. All right, so click on this one. Not gonna mess too much with this over here. You can always do edge slide. Control one. One other thing that I want to do is to bring this down a bit over here. So we can get a nice arch over here in this area here. Now I'm just going to, if I do this, you'll see that I'm gonna get vertices in there. Okay. Alright, and we now need to fix this area over here. So let's actually select this and do. No, come on, dude. Control A and slide. I'm just going to move it in a bit. So here in the back, you'll see that it's kind of, if you do tab, right, it's kind of have a wedge here. So we want to move this stuff, so it's actually mirrored over here. I'm going to move this stuff pretty slowly, right? Just want to bring out some of this stuff over here so the wedge goes away. And you can also come in here, click on these, scale them in, and maybe scale this in. And start to define a little bit of this area over here. The arm is and top view, and then maybe bring this out a bit more. One thing I like to do is where the bicep is, I'm just going to bring it out a little bit like this. Okay, it just helps to define. Now, this is the important area that allows you to bend the arm. So, this area here, as I was saying, control one, where the elbow is A to select, D select. You want to select all these over here to help the elbow move, to extrude, and you can just scale this in. And at the same time, you'll see that it gives you a nudge, but this will just help bend the elbow. I'm just going to make a quick check over here that I showed you everything that I wanted to show you. Now, just remember, typically when you're actually moving forward with this, this is a T pose. There's also an A pose concept. When you're sculpting muscles and stuff, texture mapping stuff, most artists want them to be on 45 degrees. But when you're actually putting your ideas together, you don't have to worry about that. I'm going to make sure that I get like the armpit area in here a little bit. Okay, I mean, it looks pretty good to me. Just want to make sure the back of the head it's fine. Okay, again, this is more, like I said, a testing model to test out our animation concept. I'm not going to do anything over there. Later do select. Okay, so we're done with this. Whew. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Thanks.